I'm delighted to have you as part of this community. Welcome, 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 curious minds, to our video that explores the ins and outs of Ted Whitten. Edward James Whitten, sister, OAM, 27 July 1933, 17 August 1995, was an Australian rules footballer who played for the Footscray Football Club in the Victorian Football League, VFL. Born and raised into a working-class family in Footscray, Whitten debuted for the Bulldogs in 1951, quickly becoming one of the league's best key position players, either at centre-half forward or centre-half back. In 1954 he won his first of five club best and fairest awards and earned a spot in the Australian team, the same year that Footscray won its first FFL premiership. Appointed as captain coach in 1957, he developed a successful but controversial game plan centred around the since outlawed flick pass, and in 1961 led the club to its second grand final appearance, losing to Hawthorn. In 1967, he broke Arthur Oliver's club record of 271 senior games and retired from playing after establishing a league record of 321 games in 1970. Whitten was also passionate about interstate football and made 29 appearances for Victoria, and was a leading promoter of State of Origin along with his South Australian sparring partner and friend Neil Knuckles Curley. After retiring, Whitten became a popular football panelist and commentator. He was diagnosed with prostate cancer in 1991, and in 1995, frail and in the final stages of the disease, received a farewell lap of honour during a State of Origin match at the Melbourne Cricket Ground, later ranked as football's most unforgettable moment. Football writers Russell Holmesby and Jim Main described Whitten as a prodigious kick, a flawless mark, and as having unequalled ground and hand skills. Nicknamed Mr. Football, he was a folk hero in Melbourne's working-class western suburbs, admired not only for his footballing abilities, but his showmanship and larrikin streak. He was inducted into the Sport Australia Hall of Fame in 1985 and elevated to legend status in 1995. During the AFL's centenary year celebrations in 1996, he was one of 12 inaugural legends inducted into the Australian Football Hall of Fame and was voted captain and centre-half-back in the AFL's Team of the Century. Western Oval, Footscray's home ground, was renamed Whitten Oval in his honour. His enthusiasm for State of Origin is marked by the East J. Whitten Legends Game, a charity match held annually since 1995. Get ready to uncover the mysteries surrounding early days as we navigate its intriguing terrain. Whitten grew up in the western suburbs of Braybrook and Footscray in Melbourne. As a youth, Whitten played for Braybrook on Saturdays and Collingwood Amateurs on Sundays. He was urged by the Collingwood Amateurs coach Charlie Utting, a former Collingwood VFL star, to try out for the Collingwood team, but was told later to come back in a few years after building up body strength. Within 12 months he was playing for Footscray, the team he had always supported. As we transition to the next segment, let's unravel the mysteries surrounding making a name and gain a fresh perspective. Whitten made his senior VFL debut in round one of the 1951 VFL season against at Punt Road Oval and joined a special group of players who scored a goal with his first kick. During the match, Don McTee Fraser, a notoriously volatile defender for Richmond, knocked Whitten out late in the third quarter. Whitten later said that Fraser did him a favour that day, hardening his attitude and making him realise that league football was a no-nonsense game that only the toughest could succeed at. In round five against at the Western Oval, Whitten kicked two goals in a 28-point win, but he suffered a serious injury to his left ankle. Although his injury responded quickly to treatment, Whitten would not play again until round eight against. In August, Whitten was called up for national service and sent to Puckapaneel in central Victoria. When Footscray qualified for the finals, club officials tried to obtain special leave for Whitten to play in the first semi-final against. The army refused to grant permission, but a last-minute intervention by the Prime Minister Robert Menzies allowed Whitten to return to Melbourne for the match. Unfortunately, Footscray lost a hard-fought game by 8 points. Get ready for an enlightening exploration as we dig into 1954 Premiership glory and understand its role in the broader context. After finally breaking their finals hoodoo the previous year, Footscray looked primed and ready to challenge for the VFL Premiership in 1954. He was a key member of Footscray's 1954 VFL Premiership victory, the club's only Premiership until 2016. Moving forward, we'll be taking a closer look at post-Premiership decline. After their magnificent grand final victory, many expected Footscray to become a powerhouse of Victorian football. However, the club faded away even though Witten continued to excel. Prepare yourself for an in-depth analysis of elevated to captain coach in this section. With superb all-round skills, Witten had the extraordinary talent of being able to kick equally well with his right and left foot. On one occasion, playing against Richmond at Footscray in the mid-Urs, he broke out of the ruck to the left from a centre bounce, ran 2 paces to balance himself, and kicked a left-foot torpedo kick for a goal. The ball was returned to the centre, bounced, and Witten burst out of the pack to the right, ran 3 paces and kicked a right-foot torpedo kick for a goal. Get ready for a thought-provoking discussion as we delve into 1961, a second crack at glory and its impact on our understanding. One of the best exponents of the flick pass, which was eventually banned, Witten was one of few football players to have the ability to play any position on the field. He was regarded by his contemporaries in the Urs and Urs as the greatest naturally talented player of his era. In the upcoming section, we'll be dissecting state versus club and exploring its implications in greater detail. Over the course of his playing career, Witten experienced conflict with the Footscray committee, none more dramatic than at the end of the 1966 VFL season, when he came close to joining after he was replaced as coach. When Footscray refused the clearance, Witten threatened to retire, and the matter was only resolved when former teammate Jack Collins took over as club president and convinced Witten to return and play under his former coach Charlie Sutton. As we embark on the next leg of our journey, let's unpack the layers of final years and examine its core elements. With the demands of coaching and playing beginning to take a toll on his aging body, Witten was allowed by the Footscray committee to play 4 games in 1970 to break Dick Reynolds' long-standing VFL record of 320 games before he retired as a player. His 321st and final game was against Hawthorn at the Western Oval, a game which Footscray won by 3 points. In Witten's last game as a player and captain coach, he gave a famous speech at three-quarter time at Western Oval to inspire his troops. The Round 5 game against Hawthorn in 1970 would see Footscray clinch the win by 3 points. The Oval. He continued to coach Footscray until the end of the 1971 season. He coached Williamstown in the 1975 VFA season. In this chapter, we'll be shedding light on off the field and its role in shaping our understanding. As well as being a star player, he appeared for Victoria on 29 occasions. Witten was a passionate promoter of the game, in particular the State of Origin competition, representing and captaining the Big V on many occasions. He was also chairman of selectors for the state team after retiring from playing football. He was a key promotional tool for the series, often featured promoting the Victorian team with his saying "Stick it right up, M." and had a profound impact on the concept during his time being associated. A notable example of this was before the 1983 game between Victoria and Western Australia, which was for the Australian Football Championships, a new format for the competition, in which Victoria had previously lost to South Australia and was on verge for the first time in history of losing all of its interstate matches in a year. On the bus ride to the ground, Witten sternly walked down the aisle and handed out cards which had the Victorian theme song, which hadn't been sung in at least 10 years, and then began to start singing the song, with the players joining in, with soon being sung with feverish enthusiasm, with it being described the players had a tone in their voice of "let's get these little bastards." He also inspired many players during his time as a selector, including Paul Roos, Danny Frawley and Jim Steins. Witten once famously said, "Years ago you had to crawl over cut glass to get one eye estate Guernsey." He worked as a football commentator on television throughout the years and as a radio commentator in the latter part of his life. Mike Brady wrote a song about him called, "It All Sounds Like Football to Me." Ted Witten is heard answering questions humorously on the song. Let's zoom in on post-career honours and understand its implications. In 1992, Witten was awarded the Medal of the Order of Australia OAM for his services to Australian football. In 1996, he was among the first batch of inductees to the Australian Football Hall of Fame, and he was one of the 12 players immediately elevated to legend status. In addition, he was selected as captain of the AFL Team of the Century. In 2009, the Australian nominated Witten as one of the 25 greatest footballers never to win a Brownlow medal. Witten is one of only three Australian rules footballers recognised as a legend of Australian sport in the Sport Australia Hall of Fame, alongside Ron Barsi and Lee Matthews. In the next segment, we'll be exploring death and legacy and its implications for our subject matter. In 1995, Witten went public with the announcement that he was suffering from prostate cancer. On 17 June, he made his final public appearance at the MCG before the State of Origin match between Victoria and South Australia. Suffering from blindness due to stroke, Witten was driven in a white convertible for a lap of honour around the MCG, accompanied by his son and three grandchildren, while Mariah Carey's song Hero was played on the PA system. He received a standing ovation from the crowd. This event was polled as the most memorable football event by the Melbourne newspaper The Age, and the moment is captured in Jamie Cooper's painting The Game That Made Australia, commissioned by the AFL in 2008 to celebrate the 150th anniversary of the sport. Witten died from cancer on 17 August 1995. His death, while expected, came as a shock to the football community. News of Witten's passing was broken live on an episode of The Footy Show. Producer Harvey Silver learned of Witten's death early in the recording of the episode but did not break the news to host Eddie Maguire and panelists Sam Newman, Wayne Schwiss, Gerry Lyon and Doug Hawkins until during the final commercial break of the episode. Hawkins in particular, who was a close friend of Witten, was emotionally distressed upon hearing the news, and could only manage to say he was a great man, Teddy. Newman, also a close friend of Witten, told host Eddie Maguire after the news was broken to the studio audience and viewers, "They say the show must go on, but if we'd known that when we started, the show wouldn't have gone on." The usual studio audience applause that came with the conclusion of the episode was replaced with a silent fade to the Footy Show motif. Writing for The Age at the end of that year, Les Carleon reflected on Witten's impact on communities in the western suburbs of Melbourne. Such was Witten's popularity that he was given a nationally televised state funeral. He had a bridge named for him, E.J. Witten Bridge, on the Western Ring Road, and a statue was erected at the Bulldogs' former home ground, Witten Western Oval in Footscray, which was also renamed in his honour. After Witten's death, his son, Ted Witten Jr., instituted the E.J. Witten Legends game in the memory of his father. The game is a charity match to raise money for prostate cancer research. Ted Witten currently rests at Altona Memorial Park in Melbourne's West. Don't forget to check out my other videos for more valuable content.